That ring any bells?
Of course, you've already met Miss Bennet, but I'm sure she
She's Vera. Well, I'm going to have to talk to her, it seems.
She's left for the day.
Tomorrow will do.
Well, there's no point in hanging around. I've got too much to lose.
But there may not be any letter. She could have been bluffing both of us.
I know, Anne, there will be. You coming with me?
Up and leave, just like that. Oh, I can't.
You'd sooner spend your time in that lousy prison.
I could be governor one day. I'm in line for it.
You're on the bottom line and you know it. If you love me.
Yes, I do love you.
We'll have to leave at the latest day after tomorrow.
Where will we go?
Anywhere, everywhere.
Look, I'll have to give notice.
There's no time. You just pack your suitcase and I'll phone you.
Well, I'll phone you when I'm ready.
Don't you try and get in touch with me. I'll phone you.
Oh, George. Well, I know so little about you.
You know everything you need to know, don't you?
Yeah. Well, hello. You still up?
I've got a problem.
Oh? What is it?
You.
Me? What have I done?
You've been socializing with an ex-con.
What ex-con? Oh, don't mean Mum.
Technically, she's out of bounds.
Come on, Mum is hardly the mafia.
Rules are rules. Now, we both got very holy about Vera socializing with Anne Yates. You're doing the same thing.
Can't compare Mum with Anne Yates. Mum's never really a real criminal.
She's a sweetheart. But having been in jail, she's got underworld connections, whether she likes them or not. I'm a social worker, I'm allowed to see her. You're a prison officer, you're not.
I've known Mum nearly all my working life.
You're not doing her any favours, I'm only thinking of her. You'd only get a talking to if you got caught, but Mum would lose her parole. Do you want to see her doing another stretch in jail?
Do you want some coffee?
You're still half asleep.
No, I'm not.
Well, open your eyes for a minute. I want you to bring this with you when I phone.
Okay. What's in it?
It's not drugs.
You sure?
Would I lie to you? Honestly, it's not drugs. Hey, I'm not going forever.
This is Miss Bennet. Look, I won't be in today. I'm not feeling very well.
Hi, Mr. Butterfield. It's a lovely day, isn't it?
It's gonna rain.
Oh, well, it'll save us some watering.
It's not sent down to save you work.
Are you upset about something? It's not Jeff, is it?
Look, what goes on between me and mine is my own business.
Sorry.
You get your work done this morning, you hear? And leave Geoffrey to do his, or I'll be down to see Miss Vernon.
Well, hang on, Dad. I'll give you a hand with that.
All right, Geoffrey. Put it down the back, will you? Then fix that trellis and get those bags of fertilizer into the shed, right? Undercover. Now, listen. Remember what I told you about you-know-what?
Yeah, right.
Oh, do you need a hand?
Oh, she's apples.
I thought she was kumquats.
That's not funny.
Jeff, what's the matter with you, Dad?
Well, you know, Dad, he's got a bonnet full of bees.
Yeah, well, he's not very happy with me. He hasn't said exactly what's wrong, he just hints. I mean, how can I put it right if he just hints?
Well, it's not you. It's me.
Oh? What have you done?
I met this girl. And I liked her. But he thinks she's bad news.
What's it got to do with him?
Well, that's what I've been thinking. Why should he make my decision for me?
Is she pretty?
Yeah, she is.
And nice?
Probably the nicest girl I ever met.
So what's the problem?
She's been in jail.
Well, he's told you, has he? I didn't think I was such bad news. How many other people's he told?
Well, he hasn't told anybody else, just me.
Yeah, well, I'd better move away before you get contaminated.
Lynn, please. Look, may I drive you home tonight? I mean, drive you back? Oh. Well, I knew you'd laugh at me.
Oh, I'm not laughing at you. It's just, so nice to find someone who doesn't think like everyone else. You had me worried for a while. Thanks.
Autopsy report. The Burke woman was a liar, all right.
No signs of injuries to the head?
No, she suffocated in the dryer, that's all.
No signs of violence? No signs of being forcibly placed in the dryer?
Didn't I tell you?
No, Sergeant, you did not.
Oh, I thought I did. Simple enough case. Got inside the dryer to hide from the others and accidentally shut the door.
I'll have Ferguson released and Nolan Burke put in solitary. I take it you'll be leaving us now.
When I've tied up a few loose ends. I still want to see Vera Bennett.
Dr. Downing, outpatient, please. Dr. Downing.
Yes, what is it?
We brought this for B. Smith, Constable.
Oh, sorry.
We haven't snuck a file into it.
Oh, it's not that. It's just the plants aren't allowed in the surgical wards.
Could I see her then, just for a minute?
I'm sorry, no visitors.
Well, could you give her this note then and ask her to write to me when she's feeling better?
I'll have to read it.
That's all right, no guilty secrets. Can you tell me how she is?
Well, nowhere near as bad as she wants us to believe.
Miss Bennett. You haven't been very well, I believe. Well, all packed to go, eh?
Oh, they don't belong to me. I'm minding them for a friend.
Friend? Well, we all need friends, don't we? I believe you and the deceased were friends.
No. Well, I knew her as a prison officer. Everyone at Wentworth did. We weren't close.
Oh, is that so?
Yes?
Hello, love. All set?
You've just saved me a phone call.
Somebody there.
Oh, I agree.
Cops.
Could say that.
Now, you listen to me. You don't know anything about me. You don't even know I exist. If you stick to that, you'll be all right.
I've got a parcel for you.
It's money. Keep it for yourself. And don't worry about it. It's clean.
Aren't you going to collect it?
I've got to clear out for a while. When I'm free and clear, I'll get in touch. Tell you where to join me.
When?